As a roasted plantain vendor, she made daily earnings of 10 cedis, enough to cater for her family of three children and an unemployed husband. Since the outbreak of COVID-19, which resulted in the imposition of the movement restriction order, her source of livelihood has been cut off, compelling her family to depend on the benevolence of the public for survival. At the time of our visit, her husband had gone out to visit a relative with hopes of returning home with a token.
My husband has gone to see a relative at Chadu with the hope of attracting some 10 cedis to help us eat. We are still waiting for his arrival.
Her youngest child, 11-year-old primary 6 pupil Abigail Bedu, wishes to eat rice as her first meal, but she has to wait for her father's arrival.
I've not eaten because of the lockdown. The new virus has come, so they say we should stay at home. My mother and my father don't have money to buy food for us.
Her two other children, Collins and Ebenezer Bedu, have since been home following the closure of schools due to COVID-19 pandemic. Auntie AC's 500 cedis working capital and Susu savings have gone into feeding the family.
We are in distress and need help from all Ghanaians. My family is at the verge of starvation. What to buy pure water, even elusas daily. Rent is another challenge because our landlord is equally distressed.
Auntie AC explained why she had to stop work.
People stopped buying the roasted plantain due to the lockdown. This led to my plantain going bad and a financial loss to me. I have since been resigned to the house. No work, hence no money to feed the family.
The Bedus are not the only ones reeling under the lockdown. A neighbor, Esther Bambil, is a hawker at the Kwame Nkrumah Circle, but she also had to stop work.
I have children, but was compelled to stay at home. Government must step in. We are at our wit's end.
Until the imposition of the movement's restriction order is lifted, families like the Bedus will continue to survive on the benevolence of donors.
We are crying out to the gender minister to turn to us, as otherwise our end is near. I believe her intervention can save us.